This is April's workshop, and I'm still studying the book, The Bible and Ecology. We can move on to that next slide. I've reached chapter 4, where the wild animals are, and he's reviewing this passage in Isaiah, which many of you may know well. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them, and the cow and the bear shall feed.
Oops. All right. Just trying to get the picture.
Their young ones shall lie down. Oops. Shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox, and the suckling child shall play on the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the cockatrice's den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. And in that day there shall be a root of Jesse, which shall stand for an ensign of the people. To it shall the Gentiles seek, and his rest shall be glorious. Mm. And that comes from Isaiah. And it's, if you go on to the next slide, it gives the chapter and verse 11:6-10, and this section shows God's purpose, that it includes animals as part of the new future, and that he's showing that we must strive towards a peaceful future between peoples and also between ourselves and the rest of creation. And I think that we can live more in harmony with this vision if we have an allotment or garden and run it organically, giving the wildlife a chance to thrive as well. Mm. So next slide. Now, we did English allotments last month, so I thought I'd sort of go around the world and see what other people do. And the French started them, a lady, Felicie Hervieux, in the Ardennes at the end of the 19th century as a Christian charity initiative to improve the lives of workers. And then another father, and who was a Christian deputy and mayor in French Flanders, took the same idea and promoted it also for workers to have a plot where they could grow vegetables. And in France, they're known as jardin ouvrier ou familial, and they're rented, as same here as from the town hall. They also have jardin partagé. These are communal gardens, and these are collectively maintained. And the idea is also for social cohesion through various activities they do on them. Now, as with our own, they fell into disrepair in the 70s. They're often on contaminated land, but now they're coming back as part of the sustainable living movement. And now the municipality is also installing solar panels and rainwater recovery systems. And they're imposing organic gardening methods and excluding chemicals. So as with ourselves, allotments are making a bit of a comeback. Okay, so it could be next month. I might either do German or American. I'll see how I get on. Okay, so the next slide. that shows a lot of links if you want to research them more in terms of learning about French allotments. Okay, so we've started planting out. Now, I put a lot of straw down on the allotment last autumn, and manure and volcanic ash, and we're sort of digging in and around the fruit bushes, we're throwing lots of red clover seeds that I kept from last year. I'm hoping that the red clover will grow up and push out the couch grass.
Oh, wonderful.
So that the straw will break up my very heavy clay soil. Mm. There's Sylvia, my younger daughter, hard at it. So the next one. Yes, that's us chucking down the red clover. And hopefully if the red clover comes up, then we won't have to weed in between the bushes, because it's quite a nightmare getting the couch grass out of the bushes without pulling out the bushes. So
all you have to do is just pull it, throw it on.
Yes, that's all I'm doing. I mean, we have dug in the sort of the mulches, the straw, the volcanic ash and the manure. Dug it in a bit and pulled out the obvious couch grass that was restarting. But now I've just chucked the red clover on top and then watered it. Mm. Luckily we have taps on the allotment for water. Yep. So that's hopefully sorting out the fruit bushes. We've got raspberry canes, raspberries and some blueberries and gooseberries.
So will the clover spread?
Well, I hope so. Yes.
It won't become like another weed and get too much of it, so.
Well, actually, red clover, some people in permaculture actually use it and grow into it.
Oh, I see. I'll
think about that, because it can get a bit thick. But I think I'm just going to take out the strimmer and strim it when it gets too much around the fruit bushes.
Right. Marisa, if I just come in a second, could I ask everyone to mute themselves? We've got a little bit of background noise, and I should have asked that at the beginning. And Michael's got his hand up. Do you want to ask something, Michael?
I think Michael is probably trying to work out, because he's on his phone.
Ah, okay. So difficult. Okay, fine.
Okay, so next slide. Now, this is a really interesting site I've found, the Garden Focused. What you do is you put in your region where you are and which crops you're growing, and then it will help you plan when to plant out the various fruits and veg. And I've done that, and it didn't load up very easily to PowerPoint, so I haven't included it. But you can just take which veg you're growing and put it into the site, and you'll get a really nice program out of how and when to do it, and it will tell you where the last frosts are for your area. And we've planted out last year's broad beans with some onion sets and last year's leek seeds. I'm a bit ahead this year because I'm going to France next month, so I've got to try and get everything planted out. And I tried a bit too soon and I lost the first lot of runner beans, but we've got more coming up. And we planted potatoes. We got chitted sets from our allotments shop. I've given a few links for growing potatoes, and basically This year we dug trenches and banked up on each side, put in some horse manure and potato fertilizer from the shop, and I've got some ash to put on next week. It's recommended you cover the shoots as they appear to encourage the tubers to spread underneath rather than just all in shoots. And we've already covered over the first shoots yesterday. And that's another link about adding enough potash. Okay, so that's things like ash. So next slide. There you can see the potato trenches. Those shoots that you can see there, yesterday we covered them over with earth, so they're no longer visible. And we're going to add ash next week. After the broad beans and onions, now we've put in, you can see at the back of the picture, we've got lettuce, kale and cabbage. And instead of using nematodes, which are quite expensive, you have to water them every day, and I don't quite feel up to it this year. We've got some copper draft excluder I found in a cupboard and put that round the vegetable patch, and then some builder's sand around that. And I'm hoping that it will deter the slugs. Okay. And we also, there's pictures of us planting them. Lettuces and kale. Nasturtiums as a companion crop. And Barbara, if you can, you can try and mute Michael. Okay, the next slide. Okay, so I've repeated a slide I did last month, but I think it's quite useful because it gives the different vegetable groups, well, at least some of them, the names of them, but also the companion plants that I'm growing with the main crop to try and protect them from different pests. And I've got nasturtiums to go with cabbages. I've thrown down a lot of borage seeds from last year with the broad beans, and I'm growing some French marigolds for the tomatoes. And I'm going to plant the leeks and carrots together, even though that mixes up the plant group. And I've also got some sage growing up in a pot, which I'll plant later. I'm going to make it's a herb spiral. I'm going to make it 1 month when I'm back from France, so that we'll have lots of herbs growing up in a spiral. The dry ones at the top and the wet ones underneath. Okay, so next slide. Those are some tools I use. The little brown wooden one is a dibber. Not quite sure what the other one is called, but it's hollow and you push it into the ground. You pull out a whole clod of earth and then you can put in a bigger plant. And the smaller one is useful for things, small seedlings. I also use a trowel. Okay, so next slide. Yeah, I found a video on how to use a hoe, which I thought was quite good fun. So I have to keep hoeing until the permaculture idea of no dig really takes off and I get rid of the couch grass for once and for all. I'm also a little bit wary of what I've done this last year because I'm not quite sure how much the straw is going to attract slugs and snails to live in, but I'll find out. But hopefully it will just be breaking up the clay soil and making it more manageable, because previous years the clay bakes into a, well, it bakes like clay in the very hot sun we get in Bournemouth, and I have to keep watering, and I just want to water twice a week in future. And actually at the moment I'm just watering once a week, so it's working quite well. So we'll see about the slugs. Okay, so next slide. Here's some more stuff in the greenhouse. Got beetroot, turnip, globe artichoke, more runner beads, French beans, carrot, cucumber, courgettes, pumpkins. The tomatoes are in the kitchen because they weren't doing anything in the greenhouse. I turned the heat off because it was using quite a lot of power, and took the tomatoes into the kitchen window. So I'm growing a lot from all those runner beans are from last year's seeds. So, and I've got loads, if anybody would like me to post them, just email Barbara and I can post some. I've got runner beans and chard and maybe beetroot from last year, loads of them. So you're welcome. Okay, and we could even start a seed bank in the autumn and swap seeds. Okay, so next one. Yes, I really like that prayer for Ukraine. Molitva za Ukrainiu. Excuse my Russian or Ukrainian. And I found a YouTube clip that actually sings it, the one underneath. I think let's say it together in English, shall we? Lord, O the great and almighty, protect our beloved Ukraine. Bless her with freedom and light of your holy rays. With learning and knowledge, enlighten us, your children small. In love pure and everlasting, let us, O Lord, grow. We pray, O Lord Almighty, protect our beloved Ukraine. Grant our people and country all your kindness and grace. Bless us with freedom, bless us with wisdom, guide into a kind world. Bless us, O Lord, with good fortune forever and ever, evermore. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. So that's the end of the presentation.